Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is Ravi Gupta. Today I'm going to talk about full lift safety valve. In today's topic, I will cover how the full lift safety valve is designed and how the full lift safety valve works and why it is called full lift safety valve. So before beginning the video, I want to tell you that I have made the video regarding full bore safety valve, improved high lift safety valve, and safety valve and relief valve difference. So if you want to know about that, please click on the I button, which will lead to the page section. From there you can watch, and if you want, I will give the description in the link below also. You can click there and you can watch from there also. So let's begin the video of the full lift safety valve. So first question asks is that why a valve is called full lift. So in full lift safety valve, when the valve is lifted due to overpressure, it allows the escaping of the steam to act upon the full area of the enlarged faces of the valve discs, lifting it to the fixed guide sleeve. So first let's see the design and then what I was talking about, I will tell you. So as you can see, this is where the steam will come and will escape from here. This is the valve, specially designed valve with a lip, and this is the guide sleeve through which the valve will be moved inside and will help to provide additional benefit of compression and surf lifting. After that, as you can see above the guide sleeve, there is a vent. And from this vent, above the vent, there is a spring carrier. So in this design, if compared with the improved high lift safety design, you will see that this full lift safety valve design prevent the direct contact of the steam to the spring carrier. And as it is preventing direct contact of the spring with the spring carrier, it is preventing the distortion of the spring due to the continuous subjected to the high pressure, okay, and hence increasing the life of a safety valve. Second thing is that the valve seat which is implemented here is specially designed. Once the valve is lifted, suppose this is a valve lifted here, once the valve is lifted, at that time the steam is acting upon this area. Once it is lifted, it is acting upon this area, means during the operation, initial operation, it is acting on this area, and after that, once it is lifted, it is acting on this area. So as the surface area is increased, therefore the lifting is sharp. So that was I was talking about a large face of the valve discs. Now by the uses of the fixed guide sleeve, it prevents the waste steam pressure acting on the top of the valve. A vent is provided which will drain any steam when the disc and the spindle guide to the atmosphere. So what I'm talking about is this: because of this valve design and the guide sleeve, this when the steam is escaping, at that time it prevents any of the steam to go and act upon the top of the valve, because it is been enclosed by the guide sleeve, so it prevents it from there acting. But suppose if there is any leakage in between the guide sleeve, in that case that amount of steam will be vented out from the vent. Now once the valve is lifted, it is lifted in this condition, and because of this design, this valve lift shape design, it will provide an additional lift, okay. And once it is lifted, this design will act on the valve larger surface area once it entered the guide sleeve and provide additional lift. When the valve fully entered the guide sleeve, it causes some of the escaping steam to be deflected downward by the bottom edge of the guide sleeve, the resulting reaction setup assisting waste steam to lift the valve into the full open position. So what is happening? Once the valve is lifted slightly, the steam will come here and it will deflect back and like this upward direction. Once it deflects back in upward direction, through this reaction, it will further push the valve inside the guide sleeve, and compressing the script, compressing the spring and providing D by 4 lift. Okay, it has been claimed by the manufacturer that together with the guide sleeve and the nozzle shaped inlet to the valve seat, full lift safety valve give full flow condition for the escaping spring. So what is the full flow escaping condition? Full flow escaping condition means D by 4 lift, allowing the steam to flow with its full pressure and without any hindrance. So two things to care is that, one thing is the, because of special design, the valve is increasing the surface area once it is lifted slightly where the steam is acting. And because of this shaped design and the shaped seat ring, the reaction set up by the valve is also further pushing the valve inside the guide sleeve and helping it to achieve full flow condition. Second thing is the, a vent is provided here so that if any steam is coming in this atmosphere region, though it will not come because of the tight arrangement, if it is come, this will be vented out through this. This arrangement is provided so that the steam is do not come in direct contact with the lower carrier of the spring, preventing any distortion because of the high temperature. Okay, so for that reason, this type of arrangement is provided. I hope you understand that how a full lift safety valve works. Apart from these two, all the things are almost same as same of the improved highly safety valve, like easing gear, compression nut and quarter arrangement. These are all provided for the same purposes, means that easing gear is provided so that we can check the operational condition of the valve. Quarter is provided to prevent the tampering of the valve by an unauthorized person, and the compression nut and compression ring is provided so that we, after the adjustment, it can be locked at that pressure. So I hope you understand how the full lift safety valve work. If you have any doubt, please do comment below. I will reply back. And please do subscribe and share my video if you like it. Please, please subscribe. Image credit goes to GH Flanagan. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.